I had come to in the car, I guess, and somehow climbed out and pulled Avery out, and she was fine. We tried to get up the embankment, but there was so much snow. We just laid there for hours and hours. I told myself and I told Avery that we probably weren't gonna make it out of here alive. And we laid there for a long time. And I don't know what hit me. I just had to get up that hill. And the hardest part to me was leaving her down there in the snow. So I left her, and every so often I'd yell down to her. And as long as I heard her, I just kept going up and up that hill. And I remember getting to the top and just crying that I had made it, and trying to put my arm over the railing to try and get someone's attention. And people were driving by, and I'm thinking, why are they not stopping? And Tina, the one that found us, stopped because she's just seen something. She wasn't sure what it was. So she is my angel. She saved our lives. I don't know what would have happened if she wouldn't have stopped. So she pulled over and came out, and I had told her, I didn't even say anything. I said, go down and get my daughter. And she was so afraid that she was in the car still and that she might not have made it. But she went down, and took her a long time to get back up with her. She'd called 911 first, thankfully. So they got there. They took her up in a van, wrapped her in blankets. She was gone on the first ambulance. And then two men had stopped also by then, because I was still on the rail and I couldn't move. My feet were, I lost my shoes in the accident. So my feet were just, it was like nothing was there. So I couldn't move. So these two older men had stopped, and they both kind of lifted me and carried me into the van. And then my ambulance came. And then they took us to Clarney. Then they airlifted me to Winnipeg. And then she came the next day after, because she had lost one boot. So her foot was not as bad, because I had laid on top of her the whole time. And I just covered her whole body with mine. And I blew my breath into her coat. I don't know. I thought it might keep her warm. So it was the longest night of my life. I couldn't believe it. And then they took me to the hospital, and they tried to save my legs, but they were just too far gone. They had put boots on my feet that were constantly pumping warm water into them, but nothing worked. So they decided to do the amputation. I had broke my arm up here. I have a great big scar here. And I had broke my arm, my wrist, and the top of my hand here. I didn't really know at the time why my arm wasn't working, because it was broken. And this wrist one I didn't see till they were cutting my coat off in the ambulance. I don't know how I made it up there. I don't know. I like to think my grandparents were there helping me. It's the only explanation. Yeah, it was a rough day. Rough night. Rough few weeks. I don't remember the first few weeks of the hospital. I was so in and out. And my mom, they flew right from Cuba. And she didn't think that I was gonna make it, which was hard on my family. You know, my mom, my grandma, my sister, my aunt Sheila, Avery's grandma, Kathy, and her daughter Laura were there constantly by our side. You know, that's pretty special. I'm lucky to have such a good family.